If you're lonely, longing for someone to hear you. If your burdens feel like more than you can bear. If you're searching for a place to just be honest. Come just as you are. If you're tired of just hoping for an answer. If you're wishing you could let your guard come down. If you feel like you can hold it all together. Come just as you are. There's no need for any hiding. At the Father's house you met with open arms. And he gives grace without condition. As you are. Nothing else, just come. There is space for everyone who feels unworthy. A place for those who never felt at home. Where you don't have to wonder if you're wanted. Come just as you are. There's a hope for you and me. His name is Jesus. He's the one who makes the broken whole again. Now there's no need for you to pick up all the pieces. Hey, come just as. Questions. Come
just as you are.
If you're lonely, longing for someone to hear you, if your burdens feel like more than you can bear, if you're searching for a place to just be honest, come just as you are. If you're tired of just hoping for an answer, if you're wishing you could let your guard come down, if you feel like you can hold it all together, come just as you are. There's no need for any hiding. At the Father's house you met with open arms, and He gives grace without condition, as you are, with nothing else, just come. There is space for everyone who feels unworthy, a place for those who never felt at home, where you don't have to wonder if you're wanted. Come just as you are. There's a hope for you and me. His name is Jesus. He's the one who makes the broken whole again. Now there's no need for you to pick up all the pieces. Hey, come just as you are. distant. Maybe you have never trusted him at all. There's safety here to wrestle with your questions. Come just as you are. If you're lonely, longing for someone to hear you, if your burdens feel like more than you can bear, if you're searching for a place to just be honest, come just as you are. If you're tired of just hoping for an answer, if you're wishing you could let your guard come down, if you feel like you can hold it all together, come just as you are. There's no need for any hiding. At the Father's house you met with open arms, and he gives grace without condition, as you are, with nothing else, just come. There is space.
Us singing some songs, is that right?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Let's just say a quick word of prayer for those who are joining us online. First of all, let us welcome you. We know that you have many options, especially in these times where you could go worship online, and we are so grateful to have you here with us. Welcome, and I pray that you will be blessed. Let us bow our heads. Father, we just want to give you thanks and praise for this opportunity to come into your courts and to worship and to praise you, dear Father. Let us now put aside everything that has gone through this week, and we just focus on you, dear God. Let our praise and our worship be lifted up to you, dear Father, with sweet fragrance, dear God. And we pray that you will accept it, dear God. Bless us. Be with those who are on their way, dear God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Our first hymn this morning is hymn number 183. Hymn number 183. I will sing of Jesus' love. Sing of him who first loved me. For he left bright worlds above and died on Calvary. That's more than enough reason for us to sing of Jesus' love. Isn't that right, church?
Amen.
Amen. Let's go. I will sing of Jesus' love, sing of him who first loved me, for he left bright worlds above and died on Calvary. I will sing of Jesus' love, endless praise my heart shall give. He has died that I might live. I will sing his love to me. Oh, the depths of love divine, earth or heaven can never know, how the sin as dark as mine can be made as white as snow. I will sing of Jesus' love, endless praise my heart shall give. He has died that I might live.
I will sing his love to me.
Nothing good for him I've done. How could he such love bestow? Lord, I owe, my heart is won. Help me now, my love to show.
And I will sing of Jesus' love, and endless praise my heart shall give.
He has died
that I might live. I will sing his love to me.
Amen. 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 Next hymn is hymn number 86. Oh, Lord my God, when I am awesome wonder, consider all the worlds thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee, how great thou art. Let's sing this wonderful hymn.
Oh, Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder, consider all the worlds thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. When through the woods and forest glades I wander, and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees, when I look down from lofty mountain grandeur, and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God is Son, not sparing, sent him to die, I scarce can take it in, that on the cross my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sins. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration, and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. When sings my soul, my Savior God to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art.
Amen. We serve a great God.
Amen.
Amen. God has been doing wonderful things in our lives. Is there somebody this morning? I'm going to give you an opportunity to have a short testimony of how great God has been in your life. Is there someone this morning?
I'll take it.
Brother Dragon, go ahead, my brother.
Good morning, South Brevard. It's been one day less 2 months since I've seen you guys. And I would have seen you a little earlier, but thanks to burial, I was delayed. I had to further out my flight. But I can tell you, when I arrived in Jamaica, the task that was before me, it was daunting. My nephew asked me to use the place, and then you would think he would go ahead and begin to prepare it. I had to show up and begin. And though it was daunting, I can assure you that God helped me through it. It is looking better now. I'm only sorry that it is going to grow back up, but it's going to be less work to get it back to where it's at now. And in the end, you've just listened to Elder Greenland. We need to make preparation for burial. I thought I could escape her just in time. It did not happen. But God helped me to deal with burial. I see what it could do. And because I'm on a ridge, that the winds were forceful. But God saw me through. Not a single thing was done except for little limbs of a tree that fell in the yard. I was able to clean them up, burn them. It doesn't look like the hurricane passed by except for the breadfruit tree. God kept me through that storm. I was alone all along. If there's anything that goes wrong, I'm on my own. But God was there with me, and he saw me through, and I'm happy to see you all in service today, serving the great King.
Amen. Thank you, Lord, for saving our dear brother and sending him back safely to us. Sister Audrey? Okay, the mic is coming to you, Sister Audrey.
Happy Sabbath, Saints.
Sabbath.
So I am super excited today, Elder Dragon. I'm going to steal two words from you, Beryl, one, two, nephew. So my nephew is here, and I thank God for the two young handsome men in my life, my son and my nephew. It's been a long road. Alex is my nephew, but he's like my son that I never carried. He's my brother's son, and I'm so proud of him as a young man, and he's finally here. He was supposed to come up before burial. Burial came, delayed him again, but he's finally here. God has kept him because he's been on his own in Jamaica since 12. His mom died way before that. Then my brother migrated, and he was on his own, and he's such a wonderful kid, not a perfect kid, but a wonderful kid. Didn't get in trouble, didn't this and that, and just a really wonderful young man at age 21 that I am truly proud of, not because he's my nephew, but just because of the way he carries himself as a young man. And I pray that God will continue to bless him. Stand up, Alex. You know, auntie's not shy. Family, that's my baby. And I pray that God will continue to love him. I mean, to protect him and church for me, give him love for me.
Amen. 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 Alex, welcome. Amen. And I hope that bright smile stays on your face. Amen, church.
Amen.
Good to have you, Alex.
Amen.
All right, our next hymn is hymn number 248, one of my favorite. There is a name that I love to hear. I love to sing its worth. It sounds like music in my ear, the sweetest name on earth. Oh, I love Jesus. And we all are to be showing our expression of love for Jesus this morning. Is that right? God saved us. God saved our family. God provided for us. God protected us. There's so much reasons for us to show and express our love for God. Is that right, church? You sound like you don't believe me, but we're still going to sing the song anyway. Let's go.
There is a name I love to hear. I love to sing its worth. It sounds like music in my ear. The sweetest name on earth. Oh, and oh, how I love Jesus.
Do you really love him? Sing,
oh. How I love Jesus, oh, how I love Jesus, my Lord, because he first loves me. Well, it tells me of a Savior's love who died to set me free. It tells me of a Savior's blood a sinner's perfect plea. Oh, and oh, how I love Jesus. Do you really love him? Sing, oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus, my Lord, because he first loved me. Yes, it tells of one whose loving heart can feel my deepest woe, who in its sorrow bears a part that none can bear below. Oh, and oh, how I love Jesus. Do you really love him? Sing, oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus, my Lord, because he first loves me. Sing, oh friends, do you love Jesus?
Oh yes, I love Jesus.
Are you sure you love Jesus?
I am sure I love Jesus.
And why do you love Jesus?
I tell you why I love Jesus.
Because he first loves me. That's the reason we all are to love him. Sing, oh, how I love Jesus. Do you really love him? Sing, oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus, my Lord, because he first loves me. My brothers, do you love Jesus?
Oh yes, I love Jesus.
Are you sure you love Jesus?
I am sure I love Jesus.
And why do you love Jesus?
I tell you why I love Jesus.
Because he first loves me. That's the reason we all are to love him. Everybody! Oh, how I love Jesus. Do you really love him? Sing, oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus, my Lord, because he first loves me. My sisters, do you love Jesus?
Oh, yes, we love Jesus.
Are you sure you love Jesus?
I'm sure we love Jesus.
And why do you love Jesus? Because he first loved me. That's the reason we all are to love him. Sing, oh, how I love Jesus. Do you really love him? Sing, oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus, my Lord, because he first loves me. Amen, church.
Amen.
You sound like you're ready to sing and worship now. Isn't that right? Amen. Hymn number 246. Worthy, worthy is the Lamb. Worthy, worthy is the Lamb that was slain. Glory. Hallelujah. Praise him. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah to the Lamb. Amen, church.
Worthy, worthy is the Lamb. Worthy, worthy is the Lamb. Worthy, worthy is the Lamb. Was slain. Glory, hallelujah. Praise him, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. To the Lamb. Savior, let thy kingdom come. Now the power of bring thy blessed millennium, Holy Lamb. Glory, hallelujah. Praise him, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. To the Lamb. Thus may we moment feel, love him, serve him, praise him still, till we all on Zion's hill see the Lamb.
praise him, alleluia, glory, alleluia, to the Lamb.
Amen, church.
Amen.
Glory, hallelujah, to the Lamb. Please stand with me as we sing hymn number 661, Holy, Holy, Holy.
Holy, 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 holy is the Lord. Holy, 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 holy is our God. He who always liveth, evermore the same. Heaven and earth he ruleth, come and praise his name.
From John 3:16 and 17. For God so loved the world that he be the only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. You may be seated. Sabbath, church. Happy Sabbath, church. Welcome to today's Children's Day. Welcome to today's Children's Day. My special welcome to our visitors and online people. My name is Courtney, and I will be helping doing your announcements today.
Happy Sabbath, so Brevard. All right, Courtney has a big outside voice. She's just not using it. Welcome back to Brother Dragon, who rightfully took his place up there. You have been away for a while. Welcome back. Brother Appleton and Sister Appleton, it's always a blessing to see you in the house of God. So welcome home. I know it may just be a short time, but welcome home. My mother is also in the audience. She comes and go ever so often. So welcome back, Mommy. Wave. Okay. We have Denton Cousin in a beautiful yellow. Happy Sabbath. Sister Doctor, there's a whole group of family right here in front of you, or beside you. Welcome. Welcome to South Brevard. I'm looking around. There are people that God sent you here for a reason. So if we didn't acknowledge you, that's because I didn't see your names or I'm not seeing you. Sister Jones, you're always welcome just to see your beautiful face. Vacation Bible School brought some new faces. So Amaro, Kalani, and Kai, thank you for bringing Daddy. So happy Sabbath. If you see some new faces, Children's Day, we love when children bring their parents to church. So today is Children's Day, and we are saying welcome, and we're glad that you're here.
Deaconesses meet immediately after divine service.
All right, so deaconess, you are told. Pathfinders, there will be honors this afternoon from 4 to 7. So all pathfinders and older folks, if you are interested in learning some new honors, one I would love for you all us to, for all of us to know is edible wild plants. So we are having some honors this afternoon and moving forward 4 to 7 p.m. So if you're interested, come. And if you're interested in teaching, I'm sure Sister Taylor will be happy to have you teach some honors so that our young people can learn more about what is out there to be able to help them to be better Christians, better stewards, and better children of God.
All campers for Gillette are asked to meet with Sister Nikki at 5:30 p.m.
The funeral service of Sister Dulcie Maxwell will be tomorrow. The viewing starts at 12 noon, and the service starts at 1 p.m.
Health Focus Sabbath is on July 20.
Community baby shower. Sister Laura has been promoting. This is not for the church, this is for the community. If you know of any pregnant mother, any expectant mother, this is the time to reach out. There's a huge ministry to just this one act event where we can reach out. So any way that you can support, please support. If you want to take some flyers, if whatever it is that you want to do, we're asking that mothers register for the event so we know how to be able to serve them. This event is on the 21st of July at the Ugali Civic Center, starting at 12 noon. So this church family, it's new, it's different. This is not something that we're familiar with, but it's an event that can bring so much to our community. So please support our community baby shower.
There's a Pathfinder bake sale on July 27.
Deacon and deaconesses, they're having a banquet on August 25th. We haven't dressed up and come out and fellowship as a church in a while. So this is the opportunity, August 25th. There's tickets on sale. Please see Sister Linton, Sister Elliott, or Sister Johnson for tickets. Again, this is a church event. Not, they're just hosting it. They're putting it together, but the entire church is invited. Invite your friends, invite your family to come out on August 25th. So get those tickets, and it's in aid of the building fund. So do everything that you can to support this banquet.
Florida Conference Marriage Retreat, October 11th through 13th, Daytona, $599.
All right, so she's just not using her inside voice. That's what she's getting there. All right.
Florida Conference Marriage Retreat, October 11th through 13th, Daytona, $599.
All right. So, my family, couples, Florida Conference is having a marriage retreat. It's in the beautiful city of Daytona, right on the water. It's absolutely gorgeous. Register now. We want to have all the couples to go. The fee is gonna increase. The fee is for the weekend. It covers everything. It's a one fee for both. You can see us for more information. The information is out in the bulletin. So we're asking you to start planning now for October 11th to 13th. Abigail, excuse me? Everything, registration, food, room, board, everything. It includes registration. I think about it, where if you're going to an event, are they paying for you to go? Okay. So Abigail, at this moment, wants to take a time to present to the church.
Happy Sabbath, South Brevard. Okay, I just want to take the moment and say thank you to all of those, thank you to those that donated money to our youth projects. We were able to complete our project, and we can't express how thankful we are for your support. All right, so after going through our inventory and cleaning up on Sunday, we realize we are in need of a few more supplies. Could I have that on the screen, please? Thank you. All right, so we need 5 tents, 15 tarps, 5 chairs, and 4 weights to hold down our tents. Do I have 5 people willing to contribute $50 towards our tent by the raise of hands?
Right here.
Okay. Okay. Please keep your hands up. We'll have people passing out tickets for the moment. Okay. All right. Moving on. Do we have 10 people willing to contribute $25 towards our tent? Any hands? Okay. Thank you. Okay. For our tarps now. Do we have 15 people willing to contribute $20 towards our tarp? All right, we have 2 hands, 3 hands, okay. 4 hands, thank you. All right, and for our chairs, do we have 5 people willing to contribute $20 towards our chairs? Okay, we have more hands over here. Okay. Now for our weights, do we have 3 people, just 3, willing to donate $30 towards our weights? Okay, we have a hand in front of here. All right. Please keep your hand up if you could, and people will be passing out the tickets to you. Yes, Sister. All right. Thank you to those that raised their hands. Please see Sister Charles or Sister Nikki to give your donations to. In addition to the donations, we are doing another bake sale on the 27th of July. Now, I'm not sure if you're aware yet, but in your bulletins today, you may have seen a pre-order form. It looks like this. You may have seen it in your bulletins today. If you would like to contribute to our bake sale, please fill out this form and return it to me, Abigail MCLEAN, Sister Nikki, or Sister C. MCLEAN. Thank you for your time.
The family we are praying for today is Sister Cynthia Anderson and her family. So we want to keep Sister Anderson and her boys in prayer. Just want a quick reminder of our prayer box and our prayer line. So our prayer box is over there. If you have prayers, please drop in our prayer box. It's during divine time that we do pray, and we do have a prayer team that does pray over those requests, as well as our prayer line that is in our bulletin. We want to continue to keep our sick and shut-ins in our prayer. I want to say happy birthday to Genesis. It's a Sabbath birthday, so happy birthday to Genesis. Today is her birthday, and we've seen in the bulletin the other birthday. Also, happy, happy, happy anniversary to Brother and Sister Segree. It's also a Sabbath anniversary, so happy anniversary to Brother and Sister Segree. We also have other anniversary coming up, so I want to keep the anniversary celebrant in our prayers. We have a second reading of transfer of membership. Second reading for transfer of membership, we have Sister Carla Thomas Tomlinson is coming to us from Montego Bay, Jamaica, to the South Brevard Seventh-day Adventist Church. And this is our second reading. Sister Carla.
All right, Sister Carla is here with us. Good morning in church. We've seen and we've heard Sister Carla singing for us many times. Again, it's someone that we thought was one of our own a long time ago, but she's been trying to do that, but it's finally come through. And we just want to go through the formalities of making her official member of the South Brevard SDA Church. So can someone make a motion that we accept this young lady? Hands are going up already. Is there a second for this motion? Second. Should I ask if there's any opposition? Is there any opposition? I don't see any hands, Sister Paul, Sister Carla. You know what that means, right? You're a part of the family a long time ago. All in favor, say, by the reason of your right, and if you want to do so also, welcome Sister Carla at the end of the service. We're going to have her outside, and you could greet her and give her the right hand of fellowship. Amen, church? Amen. Amen.
All right, with that, I want to say, have a blessed Sabbath.
I'm going to invite two wonderful ladies to come stand with me. Two ladies. Sister Sigree and Sister Audrey. As you'd see on the platform this morning, and if you were here early enough for Sabbath school, you saw that it was the children, the younger children, in charge of service today. Today is Children's Day, and we thought what a wonderful way to bring in Children's Day right after we had a beautiful week of vacation Bible school. So I am Sister Taylor, the children's ministry leader, and assistants for the department, Sister Audrey and Sister Wendy. And together we work with your children here at South Brevard, and they are a blessing to us. The things that they say just melt your heart, and I don't know how in the world know that we don't like children or we have a problem with our children, because they are such a blessing. They are energetic, and this year's Vacation Bible School, we started planning early. And last week's Sabbath, I still had only one registration for Vacation Bible School. And in the week, we thought, let's not have it this week. Let's push it off until another week when we get some more registrations in, because we didn't know how much material. I'm ordering everything blindly because I really don't know how many children are actually going to be attending our Thunder Island Vacation Bible School. Well, this was Sabbath, and Sunday we came over anyway, and we spent like all day here on Sunday decorating and transforming this church to look like Thunder Island. So on Thunder Island, where they learned that Jesus is always with them, this place was transformed to look like they were on an island at a beach, and they were enjoying beautiful water and learning all about Jesus. And 20 little children showed up on Monday. 20. Saturday before, there was only one registered. And on Monday, when we started at 4 o'clock, and we had VBS from 4 till 7 every day, Monday through Friday. We were here even yesterday. And as we finished, we took everything down. So unfortunately, didn't get a chance to see all of our beautiful decorations. But our children were here. They were having a great time. It was wonderful. There was a team. We could never do this by ourselves. And I'm going to just ask the team that was helping. So let me start with, this is my favorite. Okay, I love prayer. And the prayer in the prayer shack, which was held over here, there were two people who were actually leading them out in prayer and what that was like. And Sister Greenland, please stand. She's a vet now helping us with the children. And Sister Lloyd. Sister Lloyd says, I want to help. I want to come on in. And I said, you know what? I think I have the perfect place for you to fit. And Sister Lloyd was in there with Sister Greenland, and they helped the children get through all of the prayer. And they rotate from station to station. Well, in this room to my right, this room over here, it was transformed, looked like a waterfall, cascading. And that was where they learned about their different Bible stories. And Sister Henry and Sister Brathwaite were the leaders teaching the children the different Bible stories for each day. 5 days, five different stories. And we had the craft room in the back. I think this is the room where they had the most fun. And Renee held that down like a charm. Try having a bunch of kids and teaching them how to do crafts and not messing the whole place up. Yeah, some of them even painted the door out front. There was paint all over. But that is what they did. And Renee did a fantastic job. So I just want to say thank you, Renee, for how you handled all of those children. She's in the booth this morning. And the game station, Sister Latifah was out there with the game station. And she also had help. I am looking around for them. Zaria is there, yes. But Alicia, I think she's in the back. Also helped. And of course, we know kids love to go outside, but guess what happened this week? It was a lot of rain. So we had to become creative, and they had to do a lot of things on the inside. Did they mind? No. Children love to play. And they had a wonderful time with the game station. What do you think was missing? So we had them doing the stuff, and they're here from 4 to 7. What do you think was missing? Food. And they went to the coconut shack to get food. And that Sister Grant held down the coconut shack. Sister Claire started, and Sister Grant held down the coconut shack. And this is what we did all week with our children. And it is just fitting for us to finish today by presenting them with their certificate of attendance and saying thank you to all of the parents and the guardians for entrusting your children to us for Vacation Bible School. Thunder Island was wonderful. They learned about so much about what it is like to have agape love, the kind of love that God has for us. And that's why their theme today is just that. It is agape love. Jesus loves me always. And when I call your name, children, if you'd come up, we're going to present you with your certificate of attendance. We have pictures of them as well. So this first set, this is the birth, the three-year-olds, Samir White, Dalia Pinder. Come on, Dalia. Come on up, baby. And it's okay for you to clap for them. It's okay for you to say amen. I mean, they're children. They like this. You don't need to be so, come on, people. Hello, this is a graduation from VBS, right? Okay, Amir Martin, come on down. All right, Elijah Gordon. Oh, Elijah. Kai Clark. Kai is coming, I see him. Lily Gordon. Oh yeah, that's Lily. Grayson Shepherd. Mm-hmm. Now we had, they were collecting offering too. We're doing missions offerings, and they all had a little box where they were supposed to collect offering, and this offering is going to be sent over to ADRA to help build small churches. And Grayson came in with his box, right? Grayson did his box. He said, I think there's $3 or $4 in there, but all his little coins added up, and that is perfect. Thank you so much, Grayson. Gabriel Gordon, come on, Gabriel. All right. Leilani, other Lily, the other Lily. Leilani Cumberbatch, come on down, Lily. Delia Noble, she's coming, she's behind you. Dalia. Kalani Clark.